So how do you actually build an agent-based model? Well, there's two basic ways to do that. One is to build your own model completely from scratch, just like you would any computer program. But then another way, in a way that a lot of people increasingly are choosing, is to use a toolkit that's created for agent-based modeling. And we've already at least briefly mentioned one of those toolkits, NetLogo, which is the one we'll be using throughout this course. But I just wanted to let you know that there's a suite of other toolkits available out there. So, for instance, there is the ancestor of all agent-based modeling toolkits developed at the Santa Fe Institute in the early 90s, which is Swarm, written in a language called Objective-C, which actually has gained some popularity, again, the language has, due to the fact that it is the basis for a lot of Mac OS X apps, actually. And Swarm still exists and is still used. In fact, there's still a meeting called Swarm Fest that's held every year that you can attend around the Swarm development and more generally around agent-based modeling. Repast was a toolkit built at the Argonne National Lab in part and among other places, and is written in a number of different languages at this point. It has been implemented in places others, but probably most popularly implemented in Java and has been around since the early 2000s and is pretty popular still to a large extent, still well used. Then there's Ascape. Ascape was developed in part at the Brookings Institute and was developed primarily to support the development of the Sugarscape models that were used by Josh Epstein and Rob Extell in their foundational book on agent-based modeling that's about 20 years old now. So, and then there's Mason, which was developed at George Mason University in part by Sean Luke. And is very fast and efficient agent-based algorithm. MASS is a toolkit that comes out of Hungary, developed by Laszlo Gulya and some colleagues over there, and that stands for the Multi-Agent Simulation Suite. Breve is an interesting, lightweight kind of agent-based modeling simulation toolkit that really allows you to explore some of the physical aspects of building agent-based models. And then there is NetLogo, which is the one that we'll be using for this course. So we'll be using NetLogo throughout this course. And the reason why we'll be using NetLogo is because it is a premier agent-based modeling language development library. It was designed by Uri Wilensky at Northwestern University, who's also my co-author on the textbook that you might want to pick up that accompanies this course called An Introduction to Agent-Based Modeling. NetLogo is probably and is still the most widely used agent-based modeling environment. It is also the easiest to learn in many respects. And in fact, you know, in a hands-on kind of workshop where I'm interacting with people, I can get people up and running in NetLogo in a, you know, say a three-hour workshop or something along those lines. NetLogo has a central design principle that really facilitates this. The first of all is that it has a very low threshold. Novices can build simple models in their first use in very easy to understand ways. Also has a pre-collegiate curriculum that includes complex systems and modeling. So even people at the K through 12 level, students and learners, can kind of pick up and start to understand how to use agent-based modeling. But it's also been used in university courses, which include inquiry-based modeling. News and media have also been, you know, brought in to look at the models as evidence for arguments that have been explained. So it has a very low threshold to understanding and to comprehension of the models or for creation of the models, for that matter. But the other end also has a very high ceiling. The language is expressive enough that it enables high-end complex models. Researchers should be able to read and write and publish the models. The idea is that traditionally in a lot of software modeling environments, you have the conceptual or modeler on one hand, and you have the actual software engineer, the implementer on the other hand, and they're two different people. The idea behind NetLogo, among others, is that those two people could be the same person, right? This allows you to narrow or even eliminate the gap between the modeler and the programmer, and enables very interactive model development and research. It allows interactive or iterative modeling type environments where the model developer and the model programmer are constantly communicating about the model that they're creating. It also provides the ability to share the models easily since they can be understood and worked with on a very easy to comprehend way. And because of the fact that that this gap has been eliminated between the model and the programmer, it makes it easier to verify and challenge models, which we think is important for the scientific progress of modeling. Now, there's one interesting aspect of NetLogo that I feel like I should take a second to talk about, and it makes a great story anyways, which is that Logo was first developed around 1969 and by Seymour Papert and colleagues. And Logo is, in fact, the ancestral language behind NetLogo. So in Logo, which was not developed as a multi-agent language, but really as a single-agent language, you are essentially controlling a small little turtle robot that would go out and take actions in the world. And Seymour Papert developed this with his colleagues to help try and teach children how to think from a computational perspective. And when he introduced a Logo to the classrooms, a lot of times he would use one of these actual robot type things. And to get the children to be a little more interactive with the robot, he would call it a turtle rather than a robot, right? Because, you know, children would like to play with turtles. As a result of this, the virtual realization of the agent, the physical robot agent, is also called a turtle. And in fact, to this day, NetLogo, which is a direct descendant of the Logo programming language, also refers to all agents as turtles. It doesn't mean that the agents are slow or implies anything about them. It's just what we call the basic class of agents within the NetLogo programming environment.